It was up to English aviation pioneer Thomas Sopwith to come to the rescue. Sopwith took up flying after seeing John Moisant's famous Channel crossing in 1910. He set up the Sopwith Aviation Company 2 years later and designed a tractor biplane that reached a record height of 13,000 feet. Sopwith's company produced a number of fighter aircraft during the war, which greatly contributed to Britain's air supremacy. The most famous was the Sopwith Camel, which was credited with destroying 1,294 enemy aircraft. Famously difficult to fly, the Camel was so called because the grouping of engine, guns, and pilot looked like a hump. The Sopwith design gave the fighter unparalleled maneuverability. It could fly up to 20,000 feet and had a top speed of 120 miles per hour. Designed by a team led by Henry P. Follard at the Royal Aircraft Factory in Farnborough, the SE-5A was a single-seater biplane with dihedral wings. It was the favored aircraft of the greatest Allied air aces, and its only drawback, an unreliable engine, was soon fixed with the introduction of the Viper V8. The SE-5A was the first Allied pursuit plane to carry two machine guns, a Lewis gun on the top wing, and a side-mounted Vickers gun in front of the cockpit.